Now let's see how Grasshopper as well as the Grasshopper-ARCHICAD connection works. We will use curves and division points and create ARCHICAD columns. We will be using a new Rhino project created from scratch. Open Rhinoceros 64-bit version by double-clicking its icon on the desktop. Display the new panel on the startup dialog. Select the Large Object Meter template from the list. Since we're going to have more than one program open, it's useful to split the display into two parts, one for Rhino and one for Grasshopper. Use the Control or Command keys and the right arrow or left arrow keys to resize and organize the applications on your screen. Move the Rhino application window to the left as shown on the screen. Now open Grasshopper by typing Grasshopper into the command line of Rhino. Move and resize the Grasshopper application window to the right. We'll start working in Rhino using the plan view. To create a larger area for working in plan view, double-click the top title of the Rhino view to maximize this viewpoint. The curve tool of Rhino can be found on the standard toolbar on the left. This tool also has a toggle option indicated by a small arrow at the lower right side of its command icon. Press the small arrow and select the Control Point Curve option. Draw two curves as shown on the screen. These curves don't have to be perfect. As we will demonstrate later, they can be changed at any point during the design. We can set up the whole algorithm and then change the base geometry, that is, modify the initial curves. All such changes will trickle along the algorithm. This versatility is Grasshopper's most important feature. At the top of the Grasshopper window, you can see the Parameter tab and the Component tabs. The technical term for a Grasshopper file is called a definition. A Grasshopper definition is made up of parameters and components. Parameters store data, while components process data. There is only one parameter tab, but there are many tabs with icons for different components. Components are the building blocks of Grasshopper. Everything that you build in Grasshopper is an assembly of components, which are organized under these tabs. Each tab is labeled according to the types of components it contains and is further divided into subpanels. If we look at the Curve tab, we can see the Analysis panel, the Division panel, Primitive panel, Spline panel, and so on. At the top of each panel, you'll see a few icons for the most recently used components in that panel, and then a drop-down panel that shows you the complete list of every component in that panel. There are many components in Grasshopper, so even experienced users may get confused. To help you remember what a component does, just hover over it with your mouse to see the component title along with the description of what that component does. As an example, the interpolate curve creates an interpolated curve through a set of points with tangents. Below the component panels is the canvas area. This is the main working area in Grasshopper, where you'll be connecting components together to build algorithms. We have two curves coming from Rhino, and we will reference those curves into a Grasshopper component. Click on the curve icon in the Parameters tab in Grasshopper. Let's place two curve parameters on the Grasshopper canvas. Place the first curve component from the toolbar to the canvas as shown on the screen. A search function is available here to help your work, and this is very useful if you already know what option you're looking for. Double-click on the Grasshopper canvas and type your search keyword into the appearing search box. In this case, we can type curve into the search box and choose the parameter from the available options. Please place the second curve component by typing curve into the appearing search box. So now we have two curve components on the Grasshopper canvas. As you can see, both placed parameters are orange. When Grasshopper displays a component or a parameter with orange or red, It means that something is wrong or information is missing. Click the little flag in the corner of the element to get information on the problem. The flag says the floating parameter curve failed to connect data. This means that the parameter does not contain information yet. We should point it at the curve we created earlier in Rhino. Right-click on the component and select Set One Curve from the available options. Notice that as soon as you select this option, the Grasshopper window temporarily disappears from the screen, forcing you to select the curve in Rhino. Navigate to the Rhino application window and choose the top curve. Repeat the same steps for the bottom parameter as well. Select the bottom Rhino curve this time. Both Grasshopper elements have turned to gray now, signaling their OK state. Enlarge the perspective view in Rhino by double-clicking the top node first to display all viewports, and then double-click the perspective node to enlarge it. Please note, if you click on a parameter or component in Grasshopper, the matching element will be highlighted in green in the Rhino application window. Click on one of the curve components in Grasshopper and observe as the matching curve geometry is highlighted in green in Rhino. So far, we've defined two curves. Let's continue. We would like to divide these curves into segments and connect the points on the curves with ARCHICAD columns. The next step is to move one of the curves and align the Z dimension, because currently both curves are at Z, zero level. In Grasshopper, click on the Transform Component tab and place the Move component on the canvas next to the upper curve component as shown on the screen. Connect the curve into the geometry input node of the Move component using the mouse. If you look in Rhino, a green line elevated in the Z dimension shows the result of the Move component if the Move component is selected. This happened because the motion input parameter of the Move component had a default value with a default direction set in it. However, you might prefer to specify these yourself. Double-click on the Grasshopper canvas and type unit Z in the search box. Place the unit Z vector parameter on the canvas. That will define the direction of the move. Now we will specify the value to move it in the Z direction. Number sliders are parameters that feed volatile or changeable numeric information to the Grasshopper algorithm. They can be entered using different ways. The simplest way is to type a number into the canvas search box. If we type 10 now, the search box will automatically give me a number slider. Please type 13 into the search box on your canvas and place a number slider. Double-click on the placed number slider to open its dialog. Enter 50 for the range value to define the maximum possible value as 50 meters. Move the number slider next to the unit Z component on the canvas and connect its node with the factor unit vector input node. Please also connect the other factor node with the motion node of the move component. Now the original curve in Rhino has a copy that is moved 13 meters along the Z direction. Let's continue and divide the curves. Type divide curve into the canvas search box and place the component. Connect the geometry node of the move component with the curve node of the divide curve component. Please note the green division points, defined by a default value, are displayed in the curve geometry created in Rhino. Select the divide curve component. Use the Ctrl plus C and then the Ctrl plus V keyboard shortcuts to create a copy of it on the canvas. Note that we have two curve geometries defined in Rhino. One that's in the zero plane, and another one that's moved. Connect the node of the second curve parameter with the new divide curve component as shown on the screen. Please note the changes in the Rhino perspective view. Now division points are displayed on both curves. We have not yet specified the exact number of divisions for the curves. Grasshopper currently is using a default value for the division points. Let's place another number slider by typing 14 on the Grasshopper canvas. Open its dialog and enter 40 for its range value. The very same number slider can serve more than one component. Connect the node of the new number slider with the count nodes of both divide curve components. Now we have 14 division points on both curve geometries in Rhino. By having found the division points, the beginning and end points for columns are given. We can now place the ARCHICAD elements. Navigate to the ARCHICAD tab in Grasshopper. Please note that this tab is available only after you've installed the free Grasshopper ARCHICAD Live Connection tool. Choose the column component in the ARCHICAD tab and place it on the canvas. Once the component is placed, it's displayed in orange. Connect the Points node with the Endpoint node as shown on the screen. Now the column components are displayed in red. Hover the mouse over the flag at the upper right side of the column component. The flag displays two messages. 1. Input parameter anchor point failed to collect data. 2. Connection between ARCHICAD and Grasshopper not found. The first message signals that the points have not been connected. And the second message warns us that the Grasshopper ARCHICAD live connection is not yet active. To solve the first issue, we must feed data to the column component. Connect the anchor and endpoints to the column component as shown on the screen. The points in the lower curve are the anchor points, and the points on the upper curve are the endpoints. To solve the second issue, we must open ARCHICAD and start the live Grasshopper connection. Double-click the ARCHICAD icon on your desktop to start ARCHICAD. Select the Browse for a Solo Project option in the Start ARCHICAD dialog. Click Browse and select the ARCHICAD Template 1 template file. Click Open. If the Migration Assistant appears, please select the Skip Library Migration option. Arrange the ARCHICAD application window as shown on the screen. Display the 3D window in ARCHICAD. Select Design, Design Extras, Grasshopper Connection to display the Grasshopper dialog in ARCHICAD. Click the Start Connection button. Notice that the columns created earlier are now displayed in both Rhino and ARCHICAD. Switch back to Rhino and Grasshopper, and notice that the column component on the Grasshopper canvas is displayed in gray. This means that all previous issues have been solved, and now we have a live algorithmic BIM design environment. To illustrate the versatility of the live design environment, let's modify the original curves we created in Rhino. Display the top viewpoint in Rhino and turn on the control points using the corresponding tool as shown on the screen. Change the shape of both original Rhino curves by dragging the control points to a new location. Notice that the distribution of the columns is updated instantly. Let's modify the geometry of the other curve as well. Let's switch to ARCHICAD now, and please notice that the geometry of the columns is instantly and automatically updated in ARCHICAD as well. There's no need to press any button or issue any command. Thanks to the live algorithmic BIM design environment, all design changes are instantly carried out in all applications. Select any of the columns in ARCHICAD, and notice that these elements are displayed as locked by default. This is to prevent any accidental change in ARCHICAD to those elements that are connected with Rhino and Grasshopper. Let's return to Rhino and Grasshopper, and use the number slider to increase the number of division points along the curves. Click on the number slider that we placed earlier to feed the divide curve component and modify the number of division points. Notice that the number of columns are updated instantly in Rhino and updated instantly in ARCHICAD as well. We can also have access to the ARCHICAD column settings in Grasshopper. Return to Grasshopper and make sure that the ARCHICAD tab is displayed. Find the column settings component and place it on the canvas. Right-click on the building material input node of the column setting component. Select the Set One Building Material option from the available options. Choose Brick Structural from the available ARCHICAD materials. Connect the column settings input nodes as shown on the screen. Notice that the building materials of the columns are instantly updated in ARCHICAD. Please remember that we can access ARCHICAD column cross-sections and other properties from the Grasshopper column settings parameter as it's displayed on the other nodes. In addition to using the column settings parameter, we can also feed the properties of an ARCHICAD favorite directly to an ARCHICAD Grasshopper element that has been previously set up in the connected ARCHICAD file. To do this, let's select Favorite Input from the ARCHICAD panel of Grasshopper and place it on the canvas. Right-click on the right empty side of the Favorite component and choose Column Favorites. You may select and use any of the favorites displayed. When ready, simply connect the Favorite node with the Column Settings node as shown on the screen. Notice that ARCHICAD already displays the columns using the properties described by the selected favorite. As we mentioned earlier, ARCHICAD is creating actual BIM elements throughout the live algorithmic design environment. This completes the exercise of creating a simple model definition using the Grasshopper-ARCHICAD Live connection.